Listen to what God said through the prophet of Isaiah in chapter 10, verse 1. He said, "Woe to those who make unjust laws, to those who issue oppressive decrees, to deprive the poor of their rights and withhold justice from the oppressed of my people, making widows of their prey and robbing the fatherless." Woe to you. We don't take advantage of helpless people. We don't take advantage of widows. We don't take advantage of orphans. It's not the way we roll, God says. What do? Then we defend them. We stand up for them. We stick our nose in there for them. Jesus used very similar language in Luke chapter 11, verse 42. He's talking to the Pharisees and he's challenging them on their lack of love for God. And they said, "But we give money, we tithe." And his response is, "Woe to you, Pharisees," similar language, "because you give God a tenth of your mint, rue, and all other kinds of garden herbs, but listen, you neglect justice and the love of God. You should have practiced the latter without leaving the former undone." Okay, so he says, don't stop giving. Don't leave the former undone. But you should have practiced the former as well. You should love justice coming out of your love for God. You see, Jesus shared his Father's heart for the oppressed and for those who are suffering injustice. The Father's heart is seen all over the Old Testament. A couple examples. In Amos chapter 5, verse 23, the people of God were saying, "But we're singing praises to you," to which God said, "Away with the noise of your songs. I will not listen to the music of your harps, but let justice roll on like a river." I love that. Let justice roll on like a river, righteousness like a never-failing stream. Have you ever seen a churning river where the water is just coming faster than you can imagine? There's power in that, isn't there? He said, "For my people, I want justice rolling like that." In Isaiah 58, verse 6, they said, "But God, we're fasting. We're going through the ritual fasts." And he said, "Is not this the kind of fasting I've chosen? To loose the chains of injustice and to untie the cords of the yoke, to set the oppressed free and to break every yoke." In other words, Jesus is saying, we don't take advantage of helpless people. We defend them.